Hi everyone, it's me Jasdeep and I'm back again with a great video on how to hardwire your mesh Wi-Fi system. For this activity, I'll be using a TP-Link Deco X60 which I got for $399 plus taxes from Best Buy, and I also got an insurance for $55 which is for 3 years, and in all I paid around $500. We'll also use a TP-Link Gigabit Ethernet port switch. This is an 8-port switch. This costed me around $22 plus taxes. I got it from the source since it's promised me the fastest delivery. Why I got a TP-Link one is because the Deco X60 is also made by TP-Link. So I did not want some compatibility issues to come in. That is why I bought both the devices of the same company. Okay, so why are we doing this hardwiring? Hardwire networking is much more reliable than a wireless one. And since my house already has Ethernet running all across and it's all terminating in the basement, so it's easy for me to set in. In case you don't have that flexibility, probably you'll need to call in an electrician who would be able to set it up for you in your house. The reason for doing this. So without Ethernet connection, I used to get around 300 Mbps in my house anywhere. And that would be on a 750 Mbps Rogers internet that I'm getting. But after doing this hardwiring, my speeds have got boosted to 600 Mbps across. So that is the advantage. The latency has also come down because when you connect your mesh Wi-Fi system, the router provides you with the lowest latency, but since it's connected wirelessly to the other unit, so you get a lot of latency. So that is why that's another hassle. And what you'll be needing is firstly the devices, the switch, secondly my Wi-Fi system. And the third thing I want to show is like my house has this flexibility wherein I'm having these Ethernet switches running all across. So probably if you have that in your house someplace, you can use this and it will be an easy setup for you. So let's get started with the setup. Okay, so first understand the blueprint. So before doing any networking, I understood how the layout of my house is and how I would be connecting my decos. So what I'm doing is I have the Rogers modem, and close to that I've plugged in my deco router. This will be my main router. A cable from here goes and gets into one of the ports that's in that room, and that externally is connected to a switch in the basement. From this switch, there are two other cables running, and these cables move all the way from the basement, one to my living room and one goes into my master room. And here is where I'm going to place my other two decos. So this Ethernet which is going into the switch will be connecting both to this deco as well as this deco, and they will get Ethernet connected and my speeds will improve. So let me show you how this is happening in my house in real scenario. Okay friends, so this is my main deco unit. How it's connected is there's a Rogers modem. From there a yellow cable connects to this one, and from here a blue cable moves all in and eliminates at this RJ45 jack. Now this one is connected on the back side to my basement. In the basement, as you can see, I've put my TP-Link switch here. So there's a cable coming from my main deco, and then I've connected two other cables, one here and one here, and both of them are connected to my two other deco routers. So let's see how they are connected. Now checking on the second deco unit. So this cable is connected to the basement switch down below, and now it's connected to this deco, and you can see this is Ethernet connected to the main deco. And similar is the scenario for the third deco that's in my house. Now let's do the litmus test and see how much speed is coming across my house. Okay, so now let's check how it appears on our deco app. So in the deco app, we have three units. One is the main router, then second is that room, which I keep moving a lot here and there. And the third is the master bedroom. So I've taken off the dad room because for demo, I think two units are good enough. And another piece of advice is if your house is not that big enough and if you have three deco routers, I would say try with two if you can get a good connection. Don't put on the third because it can cause a lot of interference. So if I see the master bedroom, it shows it's connected via Ethernet to the main unit, which is good enough. And through this, friends, one more thing is that you get a very good handoff that's happening between the devices. And secondly, the speeds have improved. So let's move on and do the litmus test of speed. So now this one is connected to the main deco router, which is right here. So let's see how much speed are we getting.
Okay, 525 down. And close to 32 up. So that's not bad. Let's try running this test one more time. And see. So important thing to note that this device is not a Wi-Fi 6 device. This is just a Wi-Fi 5 device. And I don't have a fiber to the home right now. I'm using just a cable internet. So pretty consistent around 532. Now let's take this device and do a test in the master bedroom. Now I'm in my master bedroom and this one is connected to this unit here. So let's do a speed test and see. The speed should be close to what I'm getting to the main unit. The ping is 12, jitter is close to 3 milliseconds, which is the same as what I'm getting to the main unit. And see, as we can see, the speed is also close to 500 and the upload speed is 30, 32. So this is what I'm also getting in the main floor. The good part is when I was connected through wireless connection to the next deco, the speed were close to 300 to 320, which has now improved to 501. Now let's move on to the kitchen where I used to get the least amount of speed and see how much I'm getting there. Okay, so now we are in the kitchen. Here I used to get around 100, 200 odd. Now let's see after doing the Ethernet connection, how has the range been? So pretty substantial improvement you can see. It's almost double of what I used to get with the wireless versus what I'm getting with the Ethernet. So I'm getting close to 434 here. And the upload is also, wow, that's 32. So that's pretty awesome, as you can see.
Okay, so if you like the video and you are able to do a setup for yourself, please do subscribe to such more videos that will be coming up soon. And thank you for watching my video.